Have you ever thought about doing something really big to inspire your photography? Like, oh, I don't know, move to another country? Well, that's exactly what I did. Not just to inspire my photography, but I was kind of obsessed with France, and I talked my husband into quitting our jobs, selling everything, and moving to France for a year. And what I'm going to talk you through today is how that changed me and my photography skills. And I'm going to give you 5 tips of things that I learned while I was living in France. So you don't have to move to France unless you really want to. Hi, welcome back. I'm Diane and this is the PhotoFluent channel. And the goal here is to help you turn down the volume of your inner critic, get creative with your camera so that you can capture beautiful memories that you will treasure forever. Now, why did we decide to move to France? How did that work? What did I learn about photography? Well, I'm sure you have a lot of questions and here I am to answer them for you. So first of all, why France? Well, I've kind of been obsessed with France ever since I went to visit when I was younger. I just loved the people and the culture, the architecture, all of it. And between my love for France and House Hunters International, the next thing you know, we were planning a move to France. Now, we are not independently wealthy, nor wealthy at all. So we really had to do some planning and saving, and we decided to take a year off, basically a sabbatical, and do the things that we loved while we were in France. For me, that meant photography. For my husband, that meant writing. So we decided, why not have a blog while we were there? We could then share the experience of living in France with our family and friends and heck, anybody else who was interested. So I wanted to take some fabulous photos while in France, but my photo skills just weren't quite there yet. So part of the planning meant we moved to a smaller place, we downsized our life and really started saving money, and I really started trying to figure out how to make my photos better. One of the things I really struggled with was camera settings and the technology behind photography. Yes, I had taken course after course in person and online, read books, and it just didn't quite click for me. So I was determined to figure that out because I had come back from trips like, oh, say Japan, with photos that weren't great. They actually kind of sucked. And I thought, I'm not moving to France for a year and coming back with bad photos. So I dug in and I really got that camera out and I figured out how to get comfortable with it. So while we lived in France, we lived in Toulouse. Like I said, we had a blog and I was a photographer for the whole year. We didn't work, we were on sabbatical. So I learned a lot about myself because it's not easy to live in a foreign country. It's not just being on vacation. It's frustrating and infuriating and terrifying sometimes because you just don't know what's happening around you because we weren't fluent in French. It got better, but it was also beautiful and the experience of a lifetime. Do I recommend it? Absolutely. Well, like I said, I learned a lot about myself. I also learned a lot about my photography. And I really kind of boiled that down to 5 things. And I'm going to share those things with you so that you don't necessarily have to move to France unless you want to. So give me a like on this video if you have considered moving to another country. Okay, so let's jump into those 5 things that I learned about my photography that I want to share with you. The first thing is how to tell a story with my photos instead of just taking pretty pictures. I think before when I traveled, my approach was if I saw something pretty, I took a picture. I saw something else pretty, I took a picture. So it was more like a snapshot, a snapshot, a snapshot, here and there. But when we were in France, like I said, we had a blog, Breath of French Air. I will link to it below. And we were telling our story. We were sharing details. So it became more about a series of photos that kind of came together in a blog post. And I'm so glad that I did that. It changed my approach in a lot of ways because now, instead of just taking what's pretty, I took the details because I wanted friends and family and followers to feel like they were right there along with me. That meant pictures of our apartment, of the street we lived on, of the markets that we shopped in, of everything that we were experiencing, whether it was really pretty or not so pretty. And now I'm so glad that I have all those details because they make the best memories. And not only did my family, friends, and followers feel like they were there with me, and that's a lot of what I heard from them, the comments that I got, I feel like I'm right there. But now when I go back and look at them, it's like I'm reliving the experience. Things I would not have remembered, like the way they park. They are crazy parkers in France. The wrong way, on the street, places that aren't really a parking spot suddenly become a parking spot. And we incorporated that into a blog post. So now when I see that photo, it makes me laugh every time. Now, if storytelling with your travel photos is something you want to learn more about, I happen to have a video just on that topic. I will link to it below, and it's how to tell your travel story with photos. Okay, so tip number two that I learned when I was living in France is that there are iconic photos that you'll want to take. Let me explain. When you go to Paris, everybody's lined up taking pictures of the Eiffel Tower, and you think, well, I don't want a picture like everybody else has. But it's the iconic Eiffel Tower or the Louvre Museum, so of course you want a picture of it. And I say, get that overall iconic Eiffel Tower or the Louvre out of the way, check it off. But then think about that same subject in a different way. Take a breath and let your mind get creative. Think about different details, different aspects, different angles of that same subject. So the Louvre, for example. Now we went at sunrise to get different lighting. That's not in everybody's agenda to get up at 4 or 4:30, whenever that was, and take the metro out to the Louvre. But this way I got a very different lighting situation. It was that morning, golden hour. Now, we didn't get very close because security had it blocked off and we couldn't get close, but there are no people in this photo. And then I also got another photo as the sun came up and was a little brighter. It was harder to get the same type of photo of the overall scene because the sun became very bright. But I also love detail shots. So I got this one, which happens to be one of my favorites. And I think it's very obviously still the Louvre because of that glass pyramid. And I love the juxtaposition of the kind of modern glass pyramid with the old architecture, and it fills the frame. So it's not typical Louvre photo, but it's very obviously the Louvre. And it includes the details that I really love. So take that overall picture, even if it's the one everyone else is taking, but then step back and let your creative juices flow and think about what details that you can get that will give you more insight later when you're looking through your memories. Okay, now tip number three, I'm going to say it and you're going to roll your eyes, I'm sure of that, but it's make peace with your camera. And I know that's easier said than done. Oh, so many of my students come to me and say, I struggle with camera settings. I just don't get camera settings. I've taken classes and I still don't understand them. I know it's not easy, but I also know that you can do it. How do I know that? I did it. I struggled for years. Sometimes it's hearing it in the right way. If you need resources, I have resources. Whatever it takes, get comfortable with that camera so that when you're there, you feel confident that you will be able to get the photos that you want. One of the resources I have coming up is we're going to open enrollment for Create Amazing Travel Photos. And it's my group program that gives you all the resources and support that you'll need. I'll link to it below. Get on the wait list, and there's a special discount for those on the wait list. Now, the next tip I have, number four, is don't be afraid to try new things. That's how you're going to get unique and interesting photos instead of just the boring ones that we typically take. You know, you walk up to a scene, say we're back at the Louvre, and you just try to get the whole thing in one photo. And I think it's natural when you're traveling, you want to get as much as possible in your photos. But take a step back, take that breath again, take it all in, and think about taking unique photos, trying something different. Say, nighttime photos or blurred motion photos are fun, even at an iconic Paris street, to have people moving through the photo to show motion. It gives a different feel to your photo than just quick taking the photo and everybody's frozen. And then of course, some of my students try to avoid people in their photos. They want the photo without any people. And I used to do that too. But I think people give context, add to the culture of the photo, even if they're tourists. When you're in a touristy area and it's crowded with people, that was your experience. That's part of what makes this thing that you're looking at interesting. The Eiffel Tower is not just there by itself, it's always surrounded by tourists. And sure, if you get there really early and can take that photo without tourists, that's an interesting photo too. But don't be afraid to not only incorporate people, but try to incorporate them in an interesting way. Like this photo was made in Bordeaux, and I hesitated for a few seconds, maybe minutes, as the person walked through the frame so that I could get them in the right position in relation to the building that I wanted. So I kind of thought about it in my head. I saw people walking past and thought it would be interesting if I could get the building with someone walking in front of it. It gives context. It helps you see the scale of what you're looking at. It can add interest to your photo. So don't be afraid to put people in there. And if you're afraid of taking people because you feel uncomfortable, that kind of leads to my next tip, which is practice before you travel. Now, I also want to give the caveat, don't get out your camera and practice like, say, you're a kid at the piano with a timer next to you and thinking, I hate this. Okay, maybe that was just me. Think about it as play. Think about, I'm gonna get out my camera and play today and have fun. Set a play date every week and look forward to it. Don't look at it as work, something you dread. Look at it like something fun. I'm going to try blurred motion today. I'm going to try to get some photos of people today. People I know is a good place to start, family, friends, even neighbors. But then try to push yourself a little bit more and photograph strangers. Maybe at the local farmer's market, and maybe ask them ahead of time, is it okay if I make some photos of your stand and you? And if they say no, all you do is walk to the next person and ask them. But push yourself a little bit to try new things, get comfortable with your camera, all the things we're talking about today. If you are more comfortable, more confident ahead of time, boy, you're gonna have some good photos when you come back from that trip. And if you do enjoy learning new ways to play with your camera and you enjoy learning, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications because new content comes out on my channel every single week. So yeah, living in France for a year was amazing and frustrating and challenging and the experience of a lifetime. Do I recommend it? Absolutely. But it's not for the faint of heart. It's a lot to put together and it's not easy. It's not like you're on vacation for a year. But I hope my experiences have given you some insight. And what I want to know from you in the comments, have you ever considered living in another country? And if so, which one? So if you love the thought of telling a story with your photos instead of just random snapshots, make sure to watch my video, How to Tell Your Travel Story with Photos. And you should be able to click on that right now on the screen. And I'll also link to it below. And I'll see you there.